I would like to call the regular meeting of the Board of Trustees of October 23rd, 2012 to order. Please join the board and myself in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. Pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Clerk Bruce, would you kindly call the roll?
Trustee Actipas?
Here.
Trustee Manzo?
Here.
Trustee Moy?
Here.
Trustee Woolen?
Here.
Trustee Youssef?
Here.
Trustee Zanis?
Here.
President LaMalani?
Here. Opening comments? First of all, we will be removing item 5B from today's agenda. On Saturday, Dave and I met Christine Jones and Todd Rustenberg, who are the new co-chairs of the new ad hoc residential advancement committee. We discussed some of the projects of this new committee and what they'll be tackling as we move forward. And I'm pleased to announce that the first meeting of this residential enhancement committee will be on November 1st at 7 p.m. And I know some of you who are interested, kindly, if you're, I know, Trustee Zanis, you're interested in this committee, and maybe you can help us propel this committee in the right way, and appreciate that. November 1st, I think it's a Thursday, isn't it?
A Thursday.
Thursday, right. At 7 o'clock, yeah. Also, this time of the year, 2013 budget workshop will be held on November 8th and November 12th. Again, at 7 o'clock at the Village Hall. The Village budget will be online in a couple of days. And I encourage the residents to review the budget. And if you have any questions or issues, kindly contact the manager's office with anything that you may have in mind. And we'll be very happy to hear you out and do whatever we need to do to make it happen here. Thirdly, Trustee Moy, Zanis, Volin, Clerk Pruss, Manager Niemeyer, and I think Asif, you were there as well at the legislative lunch on yesterday held by the chamber. It was a beautiful program, and we did have a large number of CEOs representing various corporations as well as legislators who came to the chamber's event. It was so nice to see businesses getting involved with the elected officials, hopefully to address many of the issues that challenge us every day now. I think it was a great event and a testament to the good work that the chamber has done. Quick reminder about the trick-or-treat hours for the Village of Oak Brook. It should be from 4 p.m. until 8 on Wednesday, October 31st, 2012. And kindly visit the website for Halloween and other safety tips. And it's with great pleasure I'd like to announce to you today that is Trustee Asif Youssef's 50th birthday.
Hey.
Yeah. Wow. Join me in wishing Trustee Asif happy 50th birthday. And I'm so glad you have chosen your 50th birthday event to spend the time with us, which is wonderful.
Well, it's not the only thing going on today.
Oh, there are a few others?
We had the family over for an early dinner.
Okay. Thank you.
Obligation and commitment's important, but so is family time. So you've got to balance everything.
I have one tip for you.
Yes, sir.
And some of us will probably confirm this. After 50 years, it gets so much easier. Trust me, Asif.
I'm looking forward to that.
Okay.
That'd be nice.
He can join AARP now.
Yeah.
Right. I think I can get my senior coffee at McDonald's, too.
There you go.
Oh, that's good. Yeah.
Absolutely.
And finally, one of the important things that we do at this meeting is to listen to our residents and the comments that they bring up in front of us. And as you know, this is such an important thing for the board. You know, the residents are truly the pulse of this community, and we like to hear them out and do whatever we can to help them in whatever issues or questions or concerns that they may have. I actually find this very important as I move forward and plan my whatever things that we need to do for the village, and we incorporate your ideas as we move forward. However, in the recent past, and you've witnessed this in a couple of meetings recently, some trustees and actually even residents have questioned the residents who actually come to speak in front of us. And I don't have any issue with that, but most importantly, I think you need to know prior to starting any conversation, either between one resident and another, or between a trustee and a resident, the sidebar conversation, as I call it, you really need to get the approval of the chair first. But more important than that, I think we should respect our residents who come forward and bring valuable insights that they bring during this comment section. And I would like to ask every one of us who are seated here, trustees as well as senior management and myself, that we should not question any resident about issues that have nothing to do with the agenda. I don't find that acceptable. I believe it's out of line. And there's always room for improvement, and each one of us are going to improve as we move forward. Finally, if a resident wishes to speak on a village matter or an agenda item, and if you've noticed for the past year or so, we have allowed residents to come forward during the time that an agenda item is being discussed. I think it's actually good. There's freedom of speech, and ideas that pop up while the discussion is going on, we would like to hear from the residents. But I do want to insist that the residents do sign up for that. They need to sign up for either the opening residents' comments that we have that's going to follow now, or when an agenda item is being discussed, they need to sign up for that. They just can't pop up and ask a question anytime that they want to. They actually have to do that. But the message I'm trying to convey here today is that we need to be dignified and respectful with each other, whether between one resident and another in case there's a communication going on, as well as between the trustees and all of us who sit on the board here. I would actually now like to ask Trustee Wolin to expand on this issue and provide additional comments. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, President Lamalani. As a follow-up to the President's comments, at the last meeting, the board had a very lengthy discussion about an appointment to the Board of Police and Fire Commissioners. Towards the end of the discussion, Al Knuth asked for and was granted permission to offer comments regarding the appointment. Mr. Knuth made his comments, and then I asked him a question, which is what President Lamalani is, one of the things he's referring to. The question led to a misunderstanding, and in retrospect, I should not have asked the follow-up question. I now see how this had no bearing on what was being discussed, and I should not have asked this question in the public forum. Al Knuth and I have had a long and very positive relationship. We have worked together on a number of topics, and I thoroughly respect Al's commitment and his wife's commitment and actions for the good of Oak Brook. Both Al and his wife, Patty, have been very active in our community, and their contributions are very much appreciated. President Lamalani, Al and I met to discuss what took place at the last meeting. I believe that the three of us are in agreement on continuing to work together in a positive way for the betterment of Oak Brook.
Thank you.
Can I add a comment, Mr. President?
Yeah, please.
I think the points that you made are very well taken. I think some sense of order in the way we deal with comments from residents, as in all other areas of our work for the village. I think there have to be some rules that govern those exchanges, and although I think your points are very well taken, that we should always be happy to hear comments from our residents, I think we should devote a particular time of the period in which we are dealing with the subject for somebody to provide additional information. I think what has happened in the past is that the board is in the middle of the discussion, and one particular board member is trying to get the possibility of making a comment, and you might call on a resident to come and interrupt that type of discussion. I think that's probably not a very good practice. We should have particular time when the board has the ability to communicate and express each trustee express his opinion before somebody else comes in and interrupts that flow.
As you know, Trustee Actopus, this is a new thing that we've been doing for the past year or so.
Yeah.
Okay, where we have allowed residents to interact and ventilate whatever thoughts and ideas that they may have. And we are going to work through some of these issues, and no one is perfect. I certainly am not.
No, Mr. President, I am...
But what I'm saying is that this is something new that we're going to try to improve on as time goes on. And specifically in terms of what happened last time with El Canute, I need to say openly that we deeply regret the interaction that happened, and it was uncalled for, and I'm sorry that it happened. And as a chair of this body, I express my regret and apology to you, Mr. El Canute. We will try to improve. I would like to allow the residents to speak on every item on the agenda that comes up, and then the trustees can expand on that and come up to a consensus on that. So we will keep on doing whatever we can to improve the situation.
Yeah, my comments were only intended to facilitate that process. We're not critical.
That. Yeah, I appreciate that. Yeah. Can we move on to the visitor comments, if there are any?
Yes, I have a number. Mark Karambalis.
Getting good, Charlotte.
Yeah? That makes perfect, huh?
Sometimes I think, Mr. President, you read my notes. You must have been sitting next to me on some of this stuff today. But I'm not going to start out with that portion. on days that you all meet, I go home early to think and ponder, and only from time to time, as you know, I throw comments in. And generally they're pretty positive. Today's going to be a little mixed, but realistically, it's all good for all of us. The first thing I'd like to talk about today is I'd like to thank Public Works for their hard work today and every day. I got home early. It was pouring rain outside, and I drove through the subdivision. And different parts were a little bit flooded because our residents at times don't read the newsletters that are put out by the village, and oftentimes put leaves in the street, which have a tendency of clogging our storm sewers. And by the time I got home and I let the dog out, I saw two public work trucks out there picking up leaves and cleaning storm sewers. Had to be 10 minutes after the rain stopped. Very impressive. It's a good reminder at how good our village employees work for the benefit of all of us that are residents. It made me feel good inside. So, good job. The next thing I want to talk about briefly had to do with the last village meeting, which was rambunctious. I don't think it reflected well on anybody. I know we all have disagreements on different things at time. I think things can be discussed in a much calmer manner. One of the things you just addressed, and this isn't just the item that happened at the end of the Police and Fire Commission conversation. I think it's comments in general or accusations in general without any substantiating wrongdoing. I don't think comments should be made at all. And that goes for everybody. I'm telling you this as a resident that likes to come in and watch everybody. I'd like to see regression back to 6 months ago, where I think everybody on this board made a great deal of progress, not only as individuals, but made progress in the community and the finances of the community and the forward-lookingness of the community. I want you all to be very constructive, I think is the point I'm trying to make. Last time on the agenda, I didn't have time to speak on this, but I want everybody to know this. And I know nothing's going to happen, but I want you to understand how I feel. I guess I didn't read the agenda carefully enough. That's my fault. Bill Weiss, who you all were talking about, is a friend of mine. He's one of my neighbors. Bill would have done a great job on the Police and Fire Commission. I understand the wanting for Pearson to continue on, but you have a process. And if he was not engaged fully in the underlying process, realistically, I think the village president's appointment choice should have been received and passed. I'm sure what we did with Peterson was proper. I'm sure the lawsuit is without merit, and I'm sure it's eventually going to get resolved, and I'm sure it'll be resolved in our favor no matter what. At this point, it's in the hands of the lawyers. And based on what we spend on lawyers' fees, I'm assuming we have very good lawyers and things will turn out for us. We are blessed, as we all know, to have fine individuals in this village, like all of you, that make a commitment to this village to get things done. And Bill Weiss, my neighbor, is one of those individuals that wants to participate with you all. And realistically, I think he would have done a great job. I always like to thank the village employees and the police and the firemen for protecting us and keeping us running smoothly, keeping us, as Trustee Zanis likes to say, the jewel of DuPage, which we are. And on that note, I'm basically done with my comments, except to wish Trustee Zanis good luck in our election. And I guess if you just vote for her, she gets 3 votes, so that would be a positive thing. Thank you.
Al Knuth.
Al Knuth, 25 Croydon Lane, York Woods. I made an attempt to get here early, but Mr. Karambelis beat me to the punch. His points are quite valid, but initially I wanted to come here and specifically address the board with anticipation as far as the remarks by the president and Mr. Woolen in a means of thank you. Much like the last meeting, I came here with a positive thing. And I think President Lamalani, you expressed it well. Your words, Mr. Woolen, and we as a group, we addressed it. Again, cool heads will prevail. And as far as the comments by Trustee Actopus, our intent here was to put closure and to put this at a level of calm. Your additional comments, I'm afraid, didn't do that, okay? So I would be cautious. I mean, we are coming to this to put a close to it, avoid embarrassment for all parties concerned. And your comments, unfortunately, I think you could have just kind of held back and just let it go. But overall, thank you very much, and let's move forward. Thank you.
Thank you. Moving down the agenda, number 5.
Oh, no.
Oh, we have some more?
Dorothy.
Oh, good.
Miska. Did I do all right with it?
Close. I'm Dorothy Mikuska. I live at 3005 Avenue Loire in Chateau Woods, and I'm here to talk about the map that's up there. And in particular, the attempt to bring to discussion and vote the annexation of Avenue of Chateau Loire. I have trouble saying that because I live on Avenue Loire in Chateau Woods, and the group that we'd like to join be annexed is Chateau Loire. They do not have Avenue Loire there. They have a couple hundred feet of a street called Avenue Laurie. They cannot spell it right. I would like to make sure that you understand that Chateau Woods does not want to be want to have anybody new annexed to that map. There is no benefit to the village of Oak Brook to annex Avenue Chateau Loire. All benefits would be for the residents of Chateau Loire. Am I too close? Okay. Neither the village nor Chateau Loire have shown any benefits. Recently, number two, the presidents of the homeowners associations overwhelmingly voted against annexation. That would have sent, that should have sent a clear message that annexation is unacceptable to Oak Brook residents. In its effort to bring young families, number three, into Oak Brook, perhaps for the purpose of increasing enrollment in Oak Brook's excellent K-8 schools, there is no proof that annexation would support that goal. Children residing in Chateau Loire attend Downers Grove K-12 schools. They would not come to ours. Oak Brook assumes an unknown fiscal liability with this proposed annexation. Number five, there is no assurance that proposed agreement with York Township to accept the financial responsibilities of public works liabilities would be long-lasting. Number six, with York Township covering public works obligations, annexed Chateau Loire would not be regarded the same as other subdivisions of Oak Brook, which receive all village services from the village of Oak Brook. Thus, annexation under these conditions still would not make Chateau Loire a full part of Oak Brook proper. Number seven, no study has been done regarding the effects on property values for current Oak Brook residents should annexation occur. Number eight, the character of Oak Brook would be compromised in terms of lot sizes smaller than Paul Butler had envisioned when establishing Oak Brook and had written into its laws and building codes. When I built my house on 1 acre lot, the code required at least 1/3 acre. I'm not sure if that is still in the books. What are the lot sizes of Chateau Loire? Do the 120 Chateau Loire homes meet Oak Brook Village's codes? Specifically, do buildings cover only 24% of the property on each size, on each lot sizes, and that is in the code? Open space is an essential quality of Oak Brook. Number nine, the proposal to annex Chateau Loire to Oak Brook lacks transparency, discussed and possibly voted by four of the six trustees without input from the residents of Oak Brook, and in spite of overwhelming opposition expressed by homeowners association presidents. With this opposition and no known advantage to Oak Brook, one wonders why any four elected trustees would support annexation if four would. While the six elected trustees and president can and should make significant decisions about the welfare of the village, the annexation of Chateau Loire affects every single resident and affects the very nature of what Oak Brook will become in the future. Therefore, every resident should have a voice in this important decision in the forming of a binding referendum. And last, Chateau Woods subdivision has had many difficulties being recognized as incorporated Oak Brook by the fire department, the police department, the library, and the village when its residents were passed over in implementation of the electric and gas program that Chateau Wood residents voted for. We had trouble having them look at the map. When requesting or requiring village services, we have often had to direct village personnel to the map of the village to demonstrate that we are truly in the boundaries of incorporated Oak Brook, as our tax bills and deeds confirm. Therefore, it would behoove the village and its trustees to govern its current citizens as they should, rather than unnecessarily adding 120 households to its responsibility and trying to relearn its village boundaries. I hope this never comes up again. Thank you.
Okay, one more person.
Anyone else?
Yeah. Jerry Saggi.
I'm Jerry Saggi. I'm at 2909 Avenue Loire, and I'm also opposed to any kind of any kind of consideration for Chateau Woods becoming Chateau Loire becoming part of this annexation to Oak Brook. We have had I've been here for 38 years, and in 38 years, I've had many times of vandalism to my house. 38 years ago, when we tried to become Chateau Woods, we were Schomburg, which was, that's what it was called at the time, tried to stop us. And I had a garbage can put in front of my house, and my house set on fire because they did not want, they thought that they were going to become part of Oak Brook. I don't know how they called themselves Chateau Loire. They're not Loire, they are Chateau Lori. And for some reason, we have a few trustees that think that they should be incorporated into our area. We have had lots of vandalism. I've had three times in the past 3 years vandalism to our house. Dorothy has had about 6 or 7 mailboxes destroyed because they come zooming through our area, and it's like they own this area. We need to put this situation to rest. Either you're going to accept them or you're not going to accept them. And I cannot understand if the presidents decided that they did not want to accept it, how a small board, 4 people, decided that they should go behind our backs and have a secret meeting, and that's exactly what happened, and try to annex them into Oak Brook. So we are very upset that this took place, and we want this situation put to rest. Thank you.
Mark Karambula.
I'll only speak for a minute. I'll speak as the vice president of Saddlebrook Homeowners Association. As all of you know, Saddlebrook absolutely does not want any further annexation into Oak Brook. I realistically thought this issue was dead, but lately I've heard whispers on this. If there was a, quote, secret meeting on this, that thoroughly disgusts me. There is no resident that I know of, and all of you know me, in Oak Brook that wants this. This is a bad thing. It's a bad thing politically, and it's a bad thing for the residents of Oak Brook. We do not need this annexation for any reason, let alone money from them or politics. This is something we, the residents of Saddlebrook, we voted on this. We do not want this. It will affect our property values. And there is nobody that I know in the village of Oak Brook that truly wants something like this to happen.
Anyone else?
No.
Thank you. As you know, this matter is off the agenda, so just for your information. Next is, can you make the comments during trustee comments instead?
Well, I don't know if they're gonna leave, and on this particular issue, I just want to voice my opinions on it while the people are here.
We don't have this on the agenda, so
okay.
We do allow residents to come and speak, irrespective of whether any item is on the agenda or not. But if the trustees want to make a comment, we will have it during the trustee comments.
I want to make, Mr. President, a general comment.
Can we do that during trustee comments, please?
Well, it is a very general comment.
We could do that during the trustee comments, Trustee Akitas.
So we can. You're not giving me the ability to.
This matter is not on the agenda for discussion. If any trustee would like to make any comments, I would appreciate that it be done during the trustee comments.
The only thing, Mr. President, if I may say so, is that I think we all need to respect each other's responsibilities, and I think it has been the tradition of this board, and I believe it's totally appropriate and legal, that a trustee can at any time express an opinion, even if it's not on the agenda. So with that, I will respectfully ask you to let me make a comment that I would like to make.
I would appreciate. We didn't have the trustee segment in the past. Now we do have a trustee segment, and that would be the appropriate forum for further discussion, particularly if this item is not on the agenda.
I would like to support both trustees' request to make a comment, and I seek a point of order.
That's my second.
I'm not opposed to trustees making comments, but at the appropriate time.
Well, I'm requesting that this is the appropriate time. The appropriate people are here. The subject is at hand. And now is the appropriate time.
If you would like us to put this on the agenda, then two trustees can put it on the agenda and it will be done at the next meeting.
I seek a point of order. I have a second.
You want to challenge the ruling of the chair?
I am.
Okay. All right.
So,
We need to vote on that.
Yes.
Yeah.
Can we have some discussion about this before we vote?
Trustee Yusuf, discussion.
I don't think at the point of order we have discussion.
No, you're challenging the ruling of the chair, and that will have to
be
voted on.
Right, but it's inappropriate under the Robert Rules of Order that this matter is discussed. It's a point of order.
Well, I'd like to discuss.
We don't have our village attorney as yet, but.
The vote that's at hand, not the underlying issue.
No, I spent some time talking to Peter about point of orders and how to execute them. And that we can veto the chair's decision.
Yes, you can.
And that it has to be voted on.
You can challenge the ruling of the chair, yeah.
And so it doesn't have to be a challenge. You could simply agree to allow the two people to speak.
As I mentioned, and I'm repeating this for the third time, this item is not on the agenda for discussion. I'd be happy to put it on the agenda for discussion if two trustees want so. And we could do it at the next meeting.
Mr. President, really, your duty at this moment
is to
ask.
Mr. President, can I speak since I had my hand up?
You're asked for a vote on this. That's
yes.
Your duty.
We could do that too. Yeah. Trustee Mansour?
There's no comment.
I'm giving the floor to Trustee Assaf first. You had your hand up earlier.
It's inappropriate, Mr. President. You're
okay, if it's inappropriate, it's inappropriate. All I want to know is if the interested parties are going to be here for a few minutes.
Yeah.
And
oh,
we
here.
Can
Peter
share
is
our
here.
Comments
Please
in the next
let's
few minutes.
Stop. Let's just
make very
his,
simple
let
question.
Make
Number two,
comments.
I would suggest, President Lamalani, and I humbly suggest that once we get through the consent agenda, maybe we move up a portion of the trustee comments section
yeah,
at
we
that time.
We could do
but
that.
That's your prerogative.
Yeah.
We have a point of order. We have a second. We have an attorney. Let's call the vote.
Let's call the vote, Mr. President.
It's on the.
I have a question on the vote, President Lamalani. I have a question on the vote. So the vote is, do the trustees get to speak now or do they have to wait their turn later in the agenda?
No. The question is...
I believe I was making that to the chair, Ms. Zanis. Thank you very much.
Yeah, but you're misinforming the misrepresenting.
If they can't... Stelios, are you going to interrupt me every time I speak? Can I make a comment?
The floor is with the trustee at this time and then...
Thank you very much. If they're not allowed to speak now, they are allowed to speak in the trustee comments, President Lamalani?
Yes.
Okay. That's what I needed to know.
You're allowed to speak whatever you want in the trustee comment. This subject is not on the agenda at this time for discussion.
And we are asking that we discuss it. As you would allow a resident to speak in the middle of something.
What I suggested, since this item is not on the agenda, that we could discuss it during the trustee segment of our agenda today.
And we are requesting that we address it now because it is a subject at hand. To make these people wait until the end, we're going to lose momentum. We have Trustee Moy who would like to speak. We have Trustee Actopus who would like to speak. Controlling the trustee's ability to speak on a subject is not open and transparent government.
This is not about control.
It is about
this
control,
This is about
sir.
Following a procedure, a parliamentary procedure.
And the
this
parliamentary
item,
procedure
Mr. President,
was point of
is
order.
Not on the agenda
we
today.
Are violating
the meeting is getting out of order. Can we everybody take
moment.
A turn?
You need to take a vote, sir. Mr. President.
I called for a point of order. There was a second. There's a vote.
Our attorney, Friedman, has the floor.
So, as I understand it, there were comments on the annexation. The trustees wished to also comment on it. The chair ruled that those comments should come during trustee comments as opposed to now when we have resident comments.
We're done with the resident comments.
Right. Yeah. If that's the ruling of the chair, then if there's a point of order, then there should be a vote on the point of order.
Okay.
Go call the roll.
Yeah. Clerk Bruce.
Trustee Actipus?
Yes.
Trustee Manzo?
No.
Trustee Moy?
Yes.
Trustee Woolen?
I'm going to vote, but I need to explain my vote. Last Thursday, President Lamalani, Elkanuth, and I had a very productive meeting. And at that meeting, we agreed that it would be better to hold off on comments until the appropriate point in time. So I'm going to vote, but I think what we need to do is we need to go back and address offline when trustees can speak. For example, if a resident makes a comment, you know, and says something derogatory about a trustee, I think the trustee should have an opportunity to respond. I really would like to hear what Dr. Moy has to say. However, based on our conversation from last week, I will stick to my word and I will vote no.
Trustee Youssef.
I will vote no and repeat my suggestion that we move up the trustee comments portion to an applicable time.
Trustee Zanis.
Yes.
Okay, I need a vote from President LaMalani. It's 3-3.
Yeah, I will move the discussion to the trustee segment, and we can rearrange the agenda later. Yeah.
And for the record, even if the president did not vote, a 3-3 tie doesn't, the point of order isn't approved on a 3-3 tie.
Moving on to approval of the minutes, 5A. May I have a motion for the approval of the minutes from the meeting of October
9, 2012? So
moved. Second?
Second.
Any discussion?
Yes.
I would like to have these minutes reviewed, Mr. President. They don't totally reflect the spirit of the meeting.
I'll second that.
You're talking about 5A, October 9?
October 9.
Okay.
Is that what you're
talking? Yes.
Do you have any corrections to the minutes?
They are kind of long and complicated, and we need to really discuss this with.
Have you brought it for our attention, the changes?
We need it writing.
Do you want to table it till next meeting?
Yeah, we'll if we can put it off to the next meeting.
Marcia, second.
Second. I'll second that.
You can do it all in favor.
Yeah. All those in favor, say yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Any objections?
That's
5A. 5A, yeah. 5C, may I have a motion for approval of the minutes from the executive meeting of August 14, 2012?
Move.
Second.
Any discussion?
Is this, excuse me, one second.
I may have confused things. I thought that motion was regarding 5A.
Yeah, that was 5A. Now we are at 5C.
5C.
5B.
Yeah. 5B has already been extracted already. Yeah. We are actually in 5C, August 14, 2012.
Yeah. So we have removed one of the minutes, correct?
That was the one you requested earlier. Mm-hmm.
Yep. Making sure. Right. Thank you.
Any second?
It's already said.
Asif seconded.
Any discussion? All those in favor say yes.
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 Any objections? Motion carried. Yeah. 5D, may I have a motion for approval of the minutes from the executive meeting of September 11, 2012?
I move.
Second?
I'll second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say yes.
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 Any objections? Motion carried. 5E, may I have a motion for the approval of minutes from the executive meeting of September 25th, 2012?
I move.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say yes?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Any objections? Motion carried. Item number 6, consent agenda. Clerk first.
All items on the consent agenda are considered to be routine in nature and will be enacted in one motion. There will be no separate discussion of these items unless a board member so requests, in which event the item will be removed from the consent agenda and considered as the first item after approval of the consent agenda. A, accounts payable for pay period ending October 19, 2012, $754,752.13. Significant items included in above. 1. Rathi Woodward for services in September 2012 in the total amount of $3,333.33. Year to date, $30,419.43. 2. Ansel, Glick, Diamond, Bush, DeConi, and Cratherford, PC, legal services. February 2012, $19,616.25. Year to date, $94,097. Total legal bills paid for 2012, $343,988.26. 3, DuPage Water Commission, September 2012, $314,228.87. B, approval of payroll for pay period ending October 13, 2012, $668,076.93. C, community development referrals. 1, referral Ace Hardware Corporation on behalf of property owner Oak Brook Kensington 1031 LLC 2222 Kensington Court Variations, wall signs and a monument sign. D, authorization to seek bids or proposals or negotiate contracts, none at this time. E, budget adjustments, none at this time. F, authorization to reject all bids, public works, building, fuel, dispenser, and monitoring system replacement project. G, ordinances and resolution. 1, resolution 2012, SRFP EXR 1208, a resolution approving the final plot for the Tracy Perillo Revocable Trust Consolidation in the Village of Oak Brook, Illinois, 60523. 2, resolution 2012, H2O IGA DWC DUP EXR 1205, a resolution approving and authorizing an intergovernmental agreement by and between the Village of Oak Brook, the DuPage Water Commission, and the County of DuPage. H, Dana Park Re-Subdivision. I, 2012, third quarter hotel motel tax receipts. J, monthly treasurer's report, September 30th, 2012. End of consent agenda.
Okay, does any board member wish to have any item removed from the consent agenda? May I have a motion to approve the consent agenda and authorize expenditures as presented?
I'll move.
Second?
I'll second.
Any discussion? May I have a roll call vote, please?
Trustee Manzo.
Yes.
Trustee Moy.
Yes.
Trustee Woolen.
Yes.
Trustee Youssef.
Yes.
Trustee Zanis.
Yes.
Trustee Actipas.
Yes.
Motion carries. As suggested by Trustee Asif Youssef on your 50th birthday, I will move the trustee segments to 10 after 10B. Right now, let's go on to 10A. It's going to be a quick one, confirmation of appointments. I would like the board to approve the reappointment of Mr. Jeff Bulin to the Oak Brook Zoning Board of Appeals. As many of you know, Jeff has served since 2002 in the ZBA, and he's performed with distinction and has been a great asset to the ZBA. I therefore make a motion to approve the reappointment of Jeff Bulin to the Oak Brook Zoning Board of Appeals to a term to expire in 2017.
Second. I'll make the motion.
He's going to make a motion, so yeah.
I'll make the motion.
I would like to recommend, please make a motion.
Yeah, I made the motion.
To approve his appointment term expiring in 2017.
Yeah. I'll second.
Second. Any discussion? All those in favor say yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Any objections? Motion carries. Next is item ordinance 2012 BD-BOT-AG 984. Trustee Wolin, would you present this ordinance and make the appropriate motion?
Yeah. Actually, when I made the request, I wasn't expecting an ordinance to be prepared. At our last meeting, the question came up as to when two trustees can request something be on the agenda. I thought it was Friday at noon. It turns out it was Thursday at noon. And I felt that we should consider moving it from Thursday at noon to Friday at noon. Now, the fact of the matter is that it's really very seldom that trustees request items be put on the agenda. And very often what happens is in the few days before the next meeting, things start getting hot and heavy and then different things come up. And that's the point in time when things are requested to be put on the agenda. Village Manager Niemeyer and I have discussed the pros and cons of this, and he has his concern, and it's a legitimate concern. His preference is to keep it Thursday at noon, because if any staff work is required, if you make it Friday at noon, that presents a problem, because the staff is busy on that Friday getting the agenda out as is.
and it's a very valid concern. Yeah, my thought goes like this. If staff work is required, by no means does it have to be done on that agenda. You know, if trustees have a concern, and this would apply to all of the trustees, not just myself. If trustees have a concern and want to get on the agenda, very often it's to have a discussion, not even necessarily to take a vote. I mean, for example, this week, you know, we heard a lot of controversy about Chateau Loire. We know, based on all the emails flying back and forth, there have been a lot of controversy. If two trustees felt it was just good to get it on the agenda so we can have an open discussion and avoid the kind of problem we ran into, you know, 20 minutes ago, it would be worth considering. Relative to Village Manager Niemeyer's point, the fact is, even if trustees request to have an agenda item put on a Tuesday or a Wednesday, the fact is, depending on what the agenda item is, the staff work could be very large and present a challenge to get it done by the next week. But I know, speaking for myself, if I request an agenda item and it's towards Thursday or Friday and staff doesn't have a lot of time to do the work, I don't expect them to do the work. Let's just get the agenda item out there and have a discussion. And if there's staff work to be done, it could be done. The item being discussed can be deferred to the following meeting for more of a resolution. So that was my thinking. I realize there are pros and cons. I'm interested in getting feedback from the other trustees. If they think it's workable and they think it's something that they would like, fine. If they disagree, so be it. Let's go on.
Trustee Actopus?
I would like to support Mr. Walling's point of view. I think I understand also David's concern, but I think now that we have the benefits of technology, which is having really the ability to, we don't have to manually prepare all the materials that are sent out to the trustees for the agenda. That really simplifies the task. It doesn't involve as much work as preparing something in a hard form. And generally, as Jerry said, the item will involve some preliminary type of discussion. And sometimes things move quite rapidly in terms of subjects that are of interest to the village. So I think that trustees should have the ability to bring a topic up until Friday afternoon, noon.
Any other comments? Yeah. Can we finish trustee comments and then you could give your input? Yeah. Trustee Zanis?
Yes. I think that if staff feels undue burden, then they should just say that. If it's noon on Friday and we're requesting an item be put on the agenda, there's nothing wrong with the staff saying that's going to take us 30 hours of research and that's going to put an undue burden on us. If they say that, I'm confident that trustees will be responsive and say, okay, I understand. Let's limit the conversation. Let's work together to find a solution. I've never known trustees to be absolutely fixed where they say, no, I'm going to cause you duress. We've never done that to the staff. So I think that it's a good idea, and that should be incumbent upon the staff to express this, the fact that they can't meet that deadline, why they can't meet it, and then we'll say, okay, well, maybe we narrow it to this scope, or what can we do to make you feel comfortable in putting it on the agenda. But I do think that it should be allowed, absolutely.
Any other trustee comments before Dave takes the floor? Yeah. Yusuf?
I understand the concern, the need for preparation. I understand the need for us to get the recommendations and backup documents in a timely manner. And I also understand that we want to be as flexible as we can. What I would suggest for everyone's consideration is that action items have to be in by Thursday. Discussion items can come in until Friday at noon. Putting an item on for discussion doesn't require the same depth of research, doesn't necessarily require people to be ready to make a decision, but we can at least start exchanging ideas so we're better prepared to address it the next weekend. I feel that won't place as great a burden on staff, nor as great a burden on us, so we have plenty of time to review it and time to ask our questions before we take action.
Gonzo, and then Dave after that.
Yeah, I agree with Asif. I think that's a suitable compromise. And I guess, Dave, if in your comments, if you can address the history of this. I know this was something that was reinstated just before the new board was sworn in. I think in speaking to Asif, this is something that went on during Kevin Quinlan's tenure here. I don't think it was something that was done while President Craig was here, Dave, or?
Well, yeah, it was formally approved as part of an ordinance about a year and a half ago. But to be very honest, it's not something that has been, I think as everybody said, has typically been used a lot. And I think there was a desire on the trustees back then to see that formalized. And again, I think Trustee Eustace's suggestion is great. You know, we'll work with whatever system you have. Just a couple points. We really, you know, right now, and the reason why it's always been Thursday is Thursday is typically also when we kind of, the village president and I kind of finish the agenda review. It's also when the staff's deadline is, and that's kind of the history of it. The fact is we've always been flexible in allowing requests past Thursday noon anyway. So it's not like we've, I think, said, you know, 12:05 p.m. and sorry. But I think, you know, Trustee Eustace, a suggestion can work. And I think how this works well, I think, as long as everybody plays well together, to be very honest. Yeah, I mean, it's just as long as we don't get in situations where, you know, we're getting 6, 7, 8 requests at noon on a Friday for whatever. That's and that's never happened. But that's, I think, as long as everybody, you know, we all work together, I think we can trust you, suggestion that it will work, so.
Did you want to amend this, Trustee Bolin?
Just a quickie. I agree with what Trustee Yusuf said. I think it's a good suggestion. And rather than try and word it correctly tonight, my suggestion is we leave it up to Dave to word it, and then we can bring it back at the next meeting.
Okay. You want to make a motion to table then?
Yeah, I'll make a motion to table it.
I'll second.
As a point.
Comment on the table?
Yeah, as a point, I mean, our original suggestion was that it be put on here for discussion.
Right.
Right, which is exactly what we're doing.
Right.
We never wanted to pass it here today.
Right.
We just wanted to start talking about it so that we can decide which way to go, and that's ultimately what happened. So
I think the concern has been that we have been informal in some occasions. Yeah. We let that happen. And then the argument was used one particular time for one particular issue to prevent a discussion. And I thought in that respect, we should really be formalizing things.
Okay, then move to table. Second. All in favor? It's
aye.
Been seconded. Yeah. All in favor of tabling this to the next meeting?
Aye.
I think it's
aye.
Being tabled. I think it's being finalized. I think you've asked Niemeyer to finalize the language and bring it
right.
back to us. That's not a table.
No,
that's a motion to formalize.
We are tabling this particular item on the agenda.
I don't think he is.
In this case, I don't think there's a distinction. I think it's clear that if it was a motion to table without a date, then I would agree that wouldn't be appropriate. It's a motion to table to
next meeting
so that these changes can be made.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All in favor of tabling this?
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. We will move now to the trustee update segment, and I'm going to start from the left this time, Trustee Bolin. And you can comment on anything, including annexation, as normally we do during trustee segment.
You're starting with me.
Starting from the left. But
I'm a man of few words. I've already said more words tonight than I normally say. I'm all talked out.
If you include the last meeting, you've already taken time for the whole year.
Right, that's right. I used up my quote. I have no comments. I would like to thank the residents for coming and expressing their opinions.
Trustee Manzo?
No comments at this time.
Trustee Actopus?
I'd like to make the comment that that I initially wanted to make. And it was a comment that I think should be clear for the residents of Oak Brook. The idea, first of all, what I want to say is that I have absolutely no information, absolutely none whatsoever that four trustees got together, tried to decide something. If that, in fact, happened, then four of our trustees would have entered into an illegal activity that is totally prohibited by the Open Meetings Act. And if indeed something like that has happened, then I think we have a real problem. I hope it never happened. Certainly, I was not part of it.
Trustee Moore, now is the time.
Thank you. And to reiterate that, Mark, there was no secret meeting. So the reason I wanted to speak was we've, the trustees who have shown support for this annexation has never really had a chance to express our opinions. I know you talked with the presidents and so forth, so I just want to have an opportunity to just give my side of what we were feeling. We're not trying to ignore the feelings of the citizens or the presidents of the different subdivisions. You know, when I first moved to Oak Brook, just about 86, the census in Oak Brook was well over 10,000. In the 2000 census, it fell to just over 9,000. And now in this last census, we're 7,800. We are a shrinking community. We're a shrinking community, and our age is getting higher, and the average age is getting higher and higher. You know, soon we'll have to rename ourselves the Oak Brook Retirement Village. But just aside, we could use a transfusion of new families. We have a committee now formed just for that purpose, to attract new families and preferably young families. Now, what if I was to say to you that you're talking about lot sizes and so forth, we want to annex some condominiums. I mean, the outcry would be double in voice, right? Condominiums in Oak Brook, are you kidding me? Well, guess what? We've already done that. We annexed the Oak Brook Club back in the late 80s. Condominiums, no lot sizes. And had we not annexed the Oak Brook Club, we wouldn't have the Jerry Wallens. We wouldn't have Jeff Kennedy's. We wouldn't have a whole core of citizens for Oak Brook Club that they're a great asset to the community. And before Oak Brook Club was annexed, Timber Trails was annexed, solid citizens, an asset to the community. Before Timber Trails, Trinity Lakes was annexed. That's my community. If we weren't annexed, I wouldn't be here. And before we were, Brook Forest were annexed. My point I'm trying to make is Oak Brook, we are what we are because of our annexations. We are who we are because of our annexations. You know, from a lot of comments I've heard about this annexation, you think we're trying to annex a trailer park. You know, last time I drove through Chateau Lure, I didn't see any rusted out cars up on cinder blocks in the front lawn. I saw attractive houses, well-kept lawns, very similar to mine. And there's concern about, oh, it's going to devalue the housing in Oak Brook if we annex them. I really don't see a foundation for that. That's like saying my house, which is similar to the houses in Chateau Lure, very modest house. That's like saying that my house is holding down the value of the bigger houses in Midwest Club or Hunter Trails and so forth. It doesn't make sense, and I see no data that supports that feeling that it will devalue other properties in Oak Brook. The residents of Oak Brook, of Chateau Lure, have bent over backwards to accommodate any economic concerns. When this issue first came up, Mike and I talked about it, and we said, you know, it's not a bad idea. It's good people in Chateau, but we can't jeopardize the revenues in Oak Brook. So we can't thin out our fire protection and street cleaning and so forth. Well, the people in Chateau have bent over backwards to accommodate any concerns. They're going to stay in the Yorktown Fire District. so our fire department will not have to cover them. They're going to stay in the York, transportation department, so that we will not have to maintain or service the streets, such as snow plowing and so forth. They're going to spend over $1 million to pay for any administrative costs and so forth. They've bent over backwards to try and accommodate any economic concerns. And when you add it up, I think Mike was one that mentioned to me that not only is Oak Brook not going to lose money on this issue, we'll probably make money. I haven't added up all the numbers, but even if it's just a push, I feel the economic concerns have been addressed. And you know, the residents of Chateau Lurie are already de facto citizens of Oak Brook. We have the chairman of the Oak Brook Infant Welfare Society lives there. The members of the Oak Brook Women's Club live there. Members of the Bath and Tennis Club live there. They already pay taxes into the Park District for Oak Brook. So de facto, they are already member citizens of Oak Brook. They just want to make it formal. And just like the Oak Brook Club, which is proven to be an outstanding asset to the community, I believe that Chateau Lurie will also prove to be a tremendous asset to the community. And that's why I feel we should give them that chance. And that's my feelings. So thank you.
Thank you very much. I think this is probably the first time that I have heard such strong comments directed to me, to listen, to hear about the subject. And, you know, I've said that before. Mark, I think it's the first time I've heard you speak so definitively about it. I've heard you say to me, I don't think it's a good idea, but to go to the podium and with vigor and conviction, and that could have happened on the phone either. So when I started hearing about all of this, I said, well, I started hearing people tell me, we killed this a year ago at the Homeowner Association president. Why is it reviving? And I said, well, I heard you guys didn't want it, but I didn't hear that it was dead. I mean, if I'm voting, you got to tell me you want it to die, so that, because I'm the one that's going to vote. So, my comment was, if homeowner association presidents have something to say, they feel strongly, have them call me, have them email me, tell me why, have them be as strong-willed about not allowing it as they have been on the other side. And I just. So I'm glad that you guys have spoken out. I definitely have a much better understanding of your perspective. And, I've heard. Thanks.
Are you then in favor or opposed to the annexation?
I didn't state that.
Undecided, yeah.
I just said, thank you for letting me know truly how you feel, how strong will you feel. Up until very recently, I didn't know that. I heard you weren't in favor of it, but you know, that doesn't mean that we can't find solution. I mean, but clearly it appears as though majority of the Homeowners Association do not want a solution. They don't want to enter into negotiations about how, is there a compromise that can be reached? For example, if we said to them, we want it gated, so you take care of the streets and you take care of everything else, and the leaves and whatever, and we have no financial obligation to you, is that acceptable? Or is compromise not acceptable at all? And those conversations we haven't had, so.
Trustee Yusuf?
You know, sometimes when you're serving as an elected office, some people don't like what you have to say, some do. This might be one of those times where nobody likes what I have to say, but I have to say what I believe. I believe that the arrangements being discussed are not detrimental to the village of Oak Brook. I believe a lot of prior concerns have been addressed. However, this is a significant action, and I do strongly believe that it should be decided by a referendum. A referendum would be non-binding, it would be advisory. We could probably get it on in April. Let the people of Oak Brook decide and tell us exactly what they want to do. Let the majority speak. I would take a pledge to abide by the results of that referendum, whatever it may be. How I would vote on it, I'm not sure, but I would look at it with an open mind. That's a decision I'll make when I'm in the polling booth. But I look forward to seeing an analysis of the numbers based on the most recent updated proposal. I don't believe there's an urgency to this, and I believe the best way for that decision to be made is by the people of Oak Brook. And whatever that decision is, again, I would take a pledge to abide by it.
Thank you. Moving down the agenda.
Can I have a comment? Because I think you asked Elaine Zenis what her position is.
Yeah,
I would like to state my position.
Okay. All right.
Trustee Moy and Trustee Yusuf have also stated their positions. I don't know what, well, I know Jerry's position. I don't know what
I'll be more than happy to say it after you're done.
But I wasn't addressing you.
Oh, I thought you said my name. My apologies.
You have the floor, Trustee Actopus.
Thank you very much. I would say that over the years that I've served with Mark on this board, I think maybe two or three times we had a difference of opinion on any issue, and that's because Mark does a wonderful job in terms of analyzing issues, and his presentations are always very much to the point and have taken into account all particular aspects and sides of every situation. On this issue, I find myself, I understand the interest of Satolwar to become part of Oak Brook. I like the fact that they have this aspiration, and I think under certain circumstances I would have considered another annexation to the village, just as Trustee Moy said about other areas, but I think if one looks at the financial issues, I think at the end of the day, Oak Brook will be undertaking an obligation that sort of will reduce the pie for the existing residents of the village. And all those various projections have been made. When you annex a community, it's like adopting a child. Maybe it doesn't cost that much now to provide food and change the diapers, but then as that child grows, you never know how things go in terms of the cost associated with it. So I have consistently been very skeptical about the advantage of us annexing Satolwar, although the people there are wonderful and I wish them the very best in their future in terms of developing and improving their community. But I have to look at this from the point of view of the village residents. And I believe in the final analysis that I'm representing them well by saying no to this. And although Trustee Yusuf would like to see a referendum, I will sort of step and say I expect if that referendum is done that the outcome will be not to approve another annexation.
Thank you. Last call, Trustee Mansell.
I guess my position. Well, Mark is absolutely correct. When this was first presented to the board, I spoke with the village manager, Dave Niemeyer, regarding the issue. Dave said one of the biggest concerns was the cost of the fire department. I then had a lengthy conversation with Chief McCullen and realized that we could not do it. We could not provide fire service. It would be too much of a financial burden to the village of Oak Brook. And at that time, I did oppose it. We were surprised that we received notification that they would remain in York District for the fire, also for the street department. This is the, I think, the first time any annexation that Oak Brook has, it hasn't cost us millions of dollars. And in fact, I think you're right, Mark. it's either a push, but that's not the reason to do it, because there'll be financial gain. You do it because this community will be an asset to the village of Oak Brook, and I believe that it will. I'm not going to repeat what Dr. Moy said, but I agree with his statements. You mentioned Jerry wouldn't be on this board. You forgot to mention me. Saddlebrook was annexed. So I wouldn't be sitting on this board. And our homes are much smaller than the homes in Midwest Club or Old Oak Brook. I support this measure because I do believe that this would be a tremendous asset to our community. I did not support it when it would be a financial burden to our community. And I'm not going to repeat what Dr. Moy said, but I do agree with his comments earlier.
Trustee Waller?
Everybody else has given their opinion, so I guess I have to say a few more words. If I were voting this minute, and there's no question, I would vote against it. And I was not one of the alleged four who were indicated they might vote for it. As is always the case, I will keep my options open until we have a final, all of the information, et cetera. First of all, I think Dr. Moy did an eloquent job of explaining reasons why. There's an overriding thing in the back of my mind that says, be very careful. Yes, the agreement with the York Fire Protection District, and yes, the agreement with York Township for the roads are very beneficial in terms of the financial picture. However, if you think down the road 10 years, okay, I see a couple of things happening. One is, you know, the people from Chateau Loire that are requesting this right now and making the commitments, you know, they're going to be retired, living elsewhere. You're going to have new people. The new people are going to say, hey, wait, we're part of Oak Brook, and we're second-class citizens. And then we're going to get into what could be a legal battle at that point in time where they want our fire department and everything else. And at the same time, if you think down the road 10 years, one of my nightmares, I do have a few nightmares, and one of my nightmares is what's happening with sales tax. And I don't know how it is in your household, but my wife does a lot of shopping, and a very large percentage is done online. And for a lot of that, she doesn't pay sales tax. And if you look at what they're thinking of doing relative to capturing that sales tax, there are some real risks for the village of Oak Brook. And it's a complicated discussion. I'm not going to go into it today. And if you look at what's happening with the state of Illinois, where they may be taking some of our sales tax revenue, we could have major financial exposures over the next 10 years. So we have to proceed very cautiously. So as of today, I'm against it. And if I were to evaluate it going forward over the next several weeks, those are some of the things that I would be considering and looking at.
One word, if I may, and that is, I agree totally with your analysis, Jerry. The only point that you might have missed is that it becomes also a political issue, and then anybody can ask to be an equal citizen, the same costs that are spent anywhere in the village, they would be entitled to, and there'll be political forces that will agree to that. So. Right.
Did you want to see? Did you sign up? Okay, we will make an exception for you. Yeah. Kindly come to the microphone. Yeah.
Good evening. I'm Barry Sadegi. I appreciate you gave me this opportunity to respond. I didn't want to talk, but because trustees, they interject some ideas, some facts, I think I have to be able to say something too. First of all, Dr. Moy, all those boundaries in Oak Brook, they were in Oak Brook. They didn't have annexation, like Timber Trail and all others. Secondly, when this Chambord Chateau Lowry was developed, Butler invited them to come to the Oak Brook. be the boundary of the Oak Brook. They did not want to come. They refused that because the developer did not want to follow the code of the Oak Brook. Now, after several years, they want to be Oak Brook. I know the president of Homeowner Association, as you know him. I asked him, what is the reason that you want to be Oak Brook, quote unquote? He says, increase the value of our property and decrease our real estate tax. Secondly, it is not that we didn't impress our idea. Last year when this came out, I left a message to a few of our trustees. They never answered me. I don't want to mention the name. And all around, the reason the population of Oak Brook dropping is not because they move out. The owner of the houses are the same. The children grown up and move away. I have three sons. They were part of the population of Oak Brook. Now they are in different state and the city. And all around, when we discuss this, no means they bring any vitality to the Oak Brook by the financial reason. The houses, some of them are foreclosure and empty, and there is no asset. If you think about juvenile people, younger people, they're coming. Younger people, they have more liability to our Oak Brook about the fire, about the police and security and traffic. And I don't think that this should be discussed in the board and few trustees decides our destiny here. Majority of the Oak Brook people are opposed that, and if this issue wants to ratify it, should be by the referendum that everybody says here. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I will make a very brief comment. First of all, I want to thank the residents who actually came here and spoke up and gave us a piece of your mind. I did bring up this very sensitive issue to the homeowners presidents back in January. And I wanted to get a feel of what the homeowners presidents actually thought about this possible future annexation. And it was overwhelmingly, I think there were 18 homeowners, if I'm not mistaken, or 19, who were opposed to the annexation. There were three that were in favor of the annexation. So with that lopsided vote that we, informal vote that I received, I actually thought the matter was dead. But of late, I think there was a sweetened or a revised proposal that was brought to us. And I'm actually going to take it back to the homeowners to discuss with them because we have a somewhat new proposal now. And I want to see what the homeowners presidents think. And this is my job for me to be a conduit to the homeowners presidents and get their feelings and so on. But I also do like Trustee Yusuf's idea of a referendum. I think we will bring it up as well when we meet at the homeowners presidents. And even though it's a non-binding referendum, I think it will give us a sense of what the pulse of the community is in terms of this annexation. So I think it's an open issue. We will look at it fairly and do the best we can to represent what the residents of the Oak Brook want. And I really think the referendum is a great idea. Yeah. I sort of don't want to convert this into a debate, so unless there's any... when the time comes for a debate, we will open it up. It's not, you know, as
right.
I
just wanted to make a quick comment, if I may, about the referendum.
Did you want to make a quick comment?
Yes, I did. That's okay.
Your name and your... Are you an Oak Brook resident?
Yes.
Okay, please, kindly come down. Yeah.
My name is Nicholas Kuda, and I'm in Chateau Woods, 2917 Avenue, Leroy. And as my neighbors have said, I am in full agreement with them relating to this issue. Okay, the meeting that you mentioned with the Homeowner Association presidents. I was at that meeting, and as you said, I believe it was 18-3 that voted against it. At that same meeting, there was a budget as to the financial arrangements. And I'm a financial person, I'm a CPA. I analyzed the numbers, and the budget made no sense to me. Payments were suggested to be made, I believe, over an either an 18 or 20 year period at $50,000 a year. You know, nowhere in there did it take into consideration what is $50,000 18 years from now worth today.
I remember your comments now.
Yes. So I want right. I want to just reiterate those comments, because as some of the others said, you know, it's impossible to know what the cost of something is going to be 5 years from now, 10 years from now. Trustee Actopus said it very, very eloquently. You know, you adopt a child, maybe the cost to adopt a child is one aspect, but then you don't know what the costs are going to be going down the road. There are a whole series of issues that, you know, that have come into play relating to this. One issue that I've seen going through the emails, and I'm not 100% certain about all these, but I've seen them, this issue about water and some kind of new systems relating to water supply and the cost relating to doing that. I don't know if there's a budget that's been proposed for what that is going to be and who that's going to cover and really what it's going to cost the residents. But there are a series of issues. But, you know, it is financial. That's one aspect of it. If we get clear information as to what the financial aspect is, then, you know, that may lead us down another path. But I have to tell you, I just moved into Oak Brook. The population of Oak Brook went up by 2. I just got married a couple months ago. We're going to have children. I'm young. My wife is young. You know, we plan on being here for the rest of our lives. That's why we waited this long to find the right home in the right place. And, you know, I'm concerned. Concerned.
Needless to say, we commend you for that, and we appreciate your good judgment.
is the remodeling done?
The remodeling is still in process because, you know, when you have the remodeling that we're considering, it's ever-changing. So yeah. We have not finalized that, but I'm hopeful that when we do come to zoning and board with respect to what we're planning on doing. But, you know, I met Michael at a Christmas party a year ago.
Yes, yes.
Okay, and we kind of had this conversation just sort of real, real cursory, real, real briefly. Mm-hmm. And you know, I look at Oak Brook as being something different. I'm going to call it something better. Okay, it is something better. And, you know, I hope that we maintain the standards, because very honestly, that's the reason why I came here, to maintain standards. I think there are issues as I've driven through, Chateau Loire. I've seen that it's not the same as the rest of Oak Brook. And I don't mean any disrespect to anybody. I don't mean any disrespect to people that live there or to their homes. A home, if that's what you like, that's fine. But I also agree with the rest of the people in our subdivision, in our association, that are saying, you know what, we're doing extra, and, you know, we're realizing that now all of a sudden the investment that we made is kind of being put up into this, how do we balance it out? So I do have a concern. So thank you very much for hearing me.
Thank you. Thank you for your comments. And I hope I see you on November 3rd again, because you're a very objective analysis of this financial analysis that you had. I remember you made it at the last meeting. So
I offer my services to do any financial calculations, any financial information that I can help be part of, because I will give it an objective perspective. I have to, by my professional standards. But again, the budget that I saw, it was numbers, but nobody really seemed to have answers as to where those numbers were coming from and where they were going.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I think we need to limit discussion, but I'm willing to entertain the comments on...
I want to respond to Mr. Kuda, because I met him, and I think it was then your fiancé.
Yes.
Yes. And congratulations. Congratulations. Just a real quick comment, Mr. President.
The referendum. We're only going to discuss referendum.
Okay, well, he mentioned the monies, and I wanted, because there is some ambiguity regarding the $1 million that's being raised. I want the residents of Oak Brook to understand that water project is not being done for Chateau Loray or Chateau Woods. That water project is being done regardless. So it's not that they're paying for the water project, just the funds we get from them, if we annex, would go towards that water project, and still, would, I don't believe, would pay for it. But there isn't an idea, and I know many residents have spoken to me about that, that we're not raising enough money to do their water project. It is not their water project. It is our water project, the Village of Oak Brook's water project. If we don't annex, that's fine. We just would do it without that million, and we'd have to find that $1 million elsewhere. But I wanted to clear that up. And regarding the referendum, very quickly, Asif, you and I have discussed this. I normally always support referendums. Problem that I have with a referendum in this case is if we've done referendums in the past for annexations, then I would agree. We've never done, and I don't know that any of those annexations would have passed the referendum, in my opinion, but very quickly. Thank you.
There's always a new chapter in life, so just because we haven't done it before doesn't mean we cannot do it in the future. So,
right, but it seems discriminatory.
That's an item for discussion at some other time. And we got to leave something for next time. And finish discussion everything today. Any other pressing issues? We need to move on to the agenda. Otherwise, to item 2, Jerry, back to you. You're the big man today.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
And
I want you to, I do want you to know I'm getting a guilt complex. Normally, Trustee Moy has the honor of having all the juicy items. Tonight, I have the juicy items.
So you're stealing the thunder away today.
You're welcome to it, Jerry.
Thank you. Okay, I'm going to make the motion. It's a long motion, and then I would like to get a second, and I'll make some comments. I move that, number one, that the Village Board authorize the execution of a grant agreement with the Illinois Department of Commerce and Economic Opportunity for installation of high-efficiency lighting in the amount of $21,659. Number two, I move that the Village Board waive competitive bidding and authorize staff to issue a purchase order to Twin Supplies, Oak Brook, Illinois, in the amount of $34,911 for the purchase of high-efficiency lighting for the Butler Government Center parking lot.
Second.
Okay, thank you.
Any discussion?
Yeah, I'd like to make some points and then open up for discussion, and also perhaps Mike Coulihan would like to say some things. This is for new lights in the parking lot. They'll be very efficient lights, save on electricity. They're good for the environment. One of the nicest things is that about two-thirds of the cost will be covered by grant money from the state of Illinois. So this is an opportune time to go ahead and do it. And if we move quickly, we get an additional $3,000 from the state of Illinois if we get it done by February 14th. So we're getting close to the deadline, and the time to move on it is tonight if there's agreement. a couple of comments. First of all, I think all of the trustees received a letter, an email from one of our residents who had concerns about, you know, why don't we just turn the lights off at night and save electricity that way. And I thought the village manager, Niemeyer, did a very nice job of explaining the safety concerns and some of the other concerns. So I have no doubt that it's desirable to keep the lights on, and since we're going to keep them on, let's make them efficient. The other aspect is we did not go out for competitive bidding, and Mike Coulihan gave reasons why that was the case. But I know this board is always concerned when we don't go out for competitive bids, so it's important that we have an open discussion on it. And if there are any concerns, let's get them aired and get our questions answered or go to Plan B. In terms of the non-competitive bid, first of all, we do have a base of reference because the state of Illinois goes through joint procurement efforts for things like lights and cars and everything else. And you get a master listing of prices that you can either buy from if you like the price or compare it to whatever you get. And these compare favorably to what's on that list. So I'm comfortable with it based on the information that Mike Coulihan has given, but if any of the trustees have further questions, by all means, let's get them out on the table.
I don't know.
Any further discussion?
I think it sounds to me like the proverbial no-brainer here. I think it's a good deal for us, and I think we should move with it. That's my comment.
Any discussion? Trustee Yusuf?
Yes.
I will be recusing myself from this vote. I have a business relationship with this company, which preceded my being elected to this board. I bought a lot of products. We retrofit a lot of lighting in our buildings. While we've had a great experience, I would not want anyone to be able to claim there was any kind of conflict of interest, which there isn't. I believe this is a fairly simple issue to evaluate, and it makes good sense. But I would not be comfortable if I did not recuse myself and did not disclose that ongoing business relationship with this individual. I didn't bring them into the village. They've been doing business with the village well before I got elected. And actually, the owner of the company is an Oak Brook resident. He's one of our top sales tax producers, which is great. But he was introduced to me by Al Knuth and evaluated the program he had, and it made sense, and I went with it. But I have had a significant business relationship, and it continues to this day, buying lighting supplies. So while I have no objection participating in the discussion, I will be recusing myself from the vote.
Point is well taken. Any other discussion?
We have a board member who said business associations for this company, and we have no competitive bidding. So I imagine Mike's antennas might be smoking right now. Just a comment.
Well, if it's good enough for Mr. Houlihan, it's good enough for me. Normally I do get concerned with non-competitive bidding, but if it's within the bids that we would have received anyway, I think we're fine. And the supporting evidence that we did explain it, I think, rather well. And if I know Mr. Houlihan was uncomfortable with it, he'd certainly speak out. So I'm fine with this item.
Mike, did you have a comment?
No, just here at your pleasure. This is about the fourth project of its type that we've done. We've done all of the facility lighting in the library, both fire stations and the entire Butler Government Center, and now this will pretty much finish us out in this with the exterior lighting. And in addition to having lower prices than the state bid, a twin electric or twin supplies also does assist us in the grant application. So we're getting more value on top of that. They keep us informed of when every DECO grant cycle is coming up. So that it's been a very productive partnership. And we're just fortunate that we can have this relationship going with an Oak Brook firm.
There's no further discussion. Can I have a roll call vote, please?
Trustee Moy?
Yes.
Trustee Woolen?
Yes.
Trustee Youssef?
I may ask a question of the village attorney.
He's recusing himself. He just made the
yes, is it correct? Abstain or
abstain.
Present?
Abstain.
Or abstain.
Trustee Zanis?
Yes.
Trustee Actopus?
Yes.
Trustee Manzo?
Yes.
Motion carries. Yeah. Trustee Woolen, back to you for resolution 1210.
Yes, once again, thank you, President Lamalani. This has to do with the purchase of a new fuel supply system for the village for our gasoline. We were given two alternatives here, a basic and an advance for more money. I'm going to make the motion first for the advanced and then provide some discussion. And obviously, if trustees prefer to think more about the basic, which is $10,000 less, then we can have a good discussion on the pros and cons of that. But I'll make the motion first. I move that the village board award a contract to the lowest responsive and responsible bidder, Accurate Tank, North Aurora, Illinois, in the amount not to exceed $36,938 for the advanced solution of the 2012 Public Works Building Fuel Dispenser and Monitoring System Replacement Project, and I approve resolution R-2012-PW-AG-R-1211, a resolution approving and authorizing the execution of an agreement by and between the Village of Oak Brook and Accurate Tank for replacement fuel dispenser and monitoring system, subject to staff and attorney review.
Second.
Okay, in terms of discussion, we have two options, the one I just gave for the $36,000 in a basic system for $26,700. The main difference, well, first of all, what is it? It's the village has a lot of vehicles. The vehicles use gas. Next to the public works, there's a place where you can, gas pumps where you can fill up your cars and trucks. And they all, and we also supply fuel to the park district and the school district. And Mike buys the gasoline in bulk, and you get a pretty good rate. By the way, I'm just out of curiosity, how much lower is it than the retail rate? Not that I'm looking to buy gas, but just out of curiosity.
It's about 50 cents.
50 cents a gallon?
At this time, it's about 50 cents. It varies, so though.
So, you know, considering the amount of gas we use, it's very substantial. Either the basic or the advanced system will supply the fuel. The difference is the monitoring and control system. And with fuel being as expensive as it is, the village staff, I think, has built a pretty clear case that it pays to get the more sophisticated monitoring system so we can get better reports and know where the gas is being used. It'll help us monitor individual vehicles and keep track of where there might be some repairs needed. And they've also suggested that we should continue providing this service to the school and the park district, but they should pay a little bit towards this, and I would agree with that, although that's not part of the motion, but I would support the staff entering those discussions. You know, the recommendation is not to gouge them, just get a little bit of money to help pay for these sorts of things. So I'm very comfortable with the advanced system, and I think the additional $10,000 in this day and age is well worth it. By the way, the system is 20 years old, and when it breaks, the parts are, I guess, almost impossible to get. So you're probably you're doing a lot of jury rigging.
Any discussion? Trustee Manzo?
I agree with Trustee Wallen. It brings greater accountability, and it's worth the additional $10,000 to bring greater accountability with the advanced system.
Any other comments? Trustee Youssef?
One point real quickly, and please correct me if I'm wrong on this, but I have some experience buying bulk fuel with the farms and stuff. If I understand it properly, the price difference is driven primarily by the fact that this is tax exempt. Is that correct?
Yes. We don't pay all taxes, and that right. We also get, there's no retail markup either.
Now on diesel, you get a bigger chunk of the, there's a bigger chunk of taxes that are not collected.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And it makes sense. It's good to have, and it's good to have a good system in place. On diesel at the farm, we see about a 75% difference. It's 75 cent difference. And a municipality buys tax exempt because they're a municipality. For farm use, you don't pay the road taxes because it's not used on the roads. But what they do is they color the fuel differently. And if you get caught driving a pickup truck, a diesel truck, with that colored fuel in there, you're in a lot of trouble. So they do have a mechanism for that. But aside from that, I think this is the way to go. The best information we get allows us to monitor things.
Any other comments? Can I have a roll call vote for the advanced solution is what you're making a motion for? Yeah. Thank you.
Trustee Wallen?
Yes.
Trustee Youssef?
Yes.
Trustee Zanis?
Yeah. Excuse me, yes.
Trustee Actibus?
Yes.
Trustee Manzo?
Yes.
Trustee Moy?
Yes.
Motion carries. Moving down to information and updates. We're done with the trustees, I hope. Are there any additional comments? Village manager, poor Dave, hasn't spoken much today.
Nothing to add today.
Brevity is appreciated. Clerk Pruss? You too.
Early voting started yesterday. And you can tell, I voted, our family voted, I expect everybody in this village to vote. The closest site, I think, for Oakbrook residents is at Yorktown Mall in what they call the outside shops or the strip mall in back, and it's next to the restaurant on the east side if I face north. They have a flag outside, they have a sign that says early voting, there's adequate parking. Monday through Friday, 10 to 7, Saturday, 10 to 3, Sunday, 11 to 3.
You can also vote at Elmhurst City Hall, but that's only Monday through Friday till 4:30. And I have a list on the website and in the office if you want to go to some of the other places. I think those are your two closest places. I want to make a point to everybody in this room. Yesterday, 9,970 people in the DuPage County voted. Today, they have over 10,000 that have voted. So please vote. It's a privilege that Americans have. Secondly, I want to change just a little bit and talk about the consolidated election for April of 2013. You know that we have packets available. We have three trustees that are up for re-election. And if you're interested in running, please come into my office 8 to 4:30, and either Kathy or myself will give you the packets. Now, the last thing I want to mention is the Fullersburg Historical Foundation, Saturday, October 27th at 1:30, Oak Brook Library, 600 Oak Brook Road, is having a presenter, Joanne Matusik, storyteller and folklore historian. And whenever he emails me, I like to just announce that this is available, and of course it's free of charge. Thank you.
Peter? Oh,
can I mention one thing? One more thing, please.
Okay, we'll make an exception to for you.
Okay, thank you. The other thing I wanted to tell you about voting, if you aren't registered to vote and you have to go to the county at 421 North County Farm Road, I have even MapQuest sheets to direct you exactly to the building. So you can put it on your GPS system or pick up a map, but that's where you have to go, and it's only good till November 3rd. So if you have to register to vote, go out there. Thank you. I'm sorry.
Thank you. Thank you, Charlotte.
Well, I have to keep everybody informed.
You took away time from Peter. Peter, did you have a report?
I have no report tonight.
That's even better. Thank you. Departmental heads, Jim?
Thank you. I wanted to thank you again for mentioning our trick-or-treat hours and also the safety information that we have on the front page of the website, but also to remind our motorists, too, that are driving up and down our streets about children that may dart out in between the blocks and to just be extra careful that day. Also, I'm pleased to report that on October 30th, our Citizens Police Academy graduation ceremony will be held, and we had 18 wonderful residents that came out and had had a great time, and I know our staff's had a wonderful time presenting the topics as well.
Thank you. Gary?
Yeah, I just wanted to inform the board that the ambulance that you approved for purchase at the beginning of the year was placed in service on October 11th, and we just want to thank you. It's going to serve us well. Thanks.
Ray? No good news either? Mike?
We will be starting the bath and tennis wetland area at the entrance to the drive to the bath and tennis. That project will start this week, and we hope to get a majority of the plantings in before the weather turns cold, with the remainder of them being planted in the spring, and that's due to the which plants like to get planted in the fall and which in the spring. So it's going to be in transition over the winter, but when things bloom in the spring, it should be a pretty dramatic change.
Thank you. Bob?
One update. In the next week or so, staff will be meeting with the General Growth folks as well as the owners of the new hotel. It's going to be about an 8 to 9 month process to renovate that hotel, so those discussions will begin. Again, they're going to put in about $25 million into that building.
Thank you. That's a lot of money. Yeah, now I have a motion to adjourn to a closed session for the purpose of discussing, number one, pending, probable, or imminent litigation matters, number two, sale or lease of property owned by the public body, and number three, minutes of the meetings lawfully closed under this act pursuant to Section 2C11, 2C6, 2C21 of the Illinois Open Meetings Act, respectively.
I'll second.
I'll move.
Not been moved yet. Oh, okay. Moved and seconded now. Okay. Can I have a roll call vote, please?
Trustee Actipus.
Yes.
Trustee Manzo.
Yes.
Trustee Moy.
Yes.
Trustee Woolen.
Yes.
Trustee Youssef.
Yes.
Trustee Zanis.
Yes.
8:47 p.m.
Meeting is adjourned. Thank you.